I work with salicylic acid-based polymers, and generally speaking, polymers are referred to as plastics. And in this case, we use salicylic acid, which is the active ingredient in aspirin, and we use them to make polymers that can be used for stents and stent coatings. Pretty much our polymers break down over time and they release the salicylic acid right where the implant is put into the body so that it relieves inflammation right at the source and it alleviates having to take aspirin or other pain relievers. The polymers that I synthesize are used to make nerve guidance conduits, and the nerve guidance conduits are essentially hollow tubes made out of our polymers, and we are trying to grow nerves in them to help repair nerve damage, specifically spinal cord injury. Pretty much the tube surrounds where the nerves would grow and creates an isolated environment where you can limit the exposure to toxins that would hinder their growth, and also hopefully they'd be small enough to help guide them to reconnect. I work for Dr. Kathryn, Uhrich in the chemistry department, and I got involved with her research through the Douglas Project, through a program called Project Super, which is for Rutgers women in math, science, and engineering. I took a class in the spring of my freshman year called Introduction to Scientific Research, or as the university calls it, ISR for short, and that class gave me research experience in mechanical and aerospace engineering. It was meant to introduce us into a lab so that we'd have lab experience that would hopefully make us more appealing to faculty at the university. Dr. Uhrich contacted Project Super and was looking for undergraduates to do research. She was looking for some chemistry majors, and I really liked her research, so that's how it got started. The first thing I do when I go into the lab is I have to synthesize my starting materials in order to make the polymers. So pretty much we react methyl salicylate, also known as wintergreen oil. If you've ever had wintergreen gum, methyl salicylate is what gives it the wintergreen flavor. We react the methyl salicylate with a linker molecule to obtain our diacid, which is our repeat unit in the polymer. We then heat the starting materials in a temperature-controlled oil bath and stir the polymer. We use low vacuum to help drive off the side products and help yield the polymer with higher molecular weight. If you're looking to do undergraduate research and you're a first year, you can contact the Uresti Research Center. And then if you're a female Rutgers student, you could also try the Douglas Project and Project Super. What I learned about from my research experience is that I really like to work on projects that have biomedical applications. I put so much time into the lab, and for me, if I didn't know that there was a chance that someone else could get something out of it, I would feel like my time was being wasted. I want to know that I'm working on something that people can use and that will hopefully help people in the future.